Hello, hello. So this presentation is with the intention of starting simplifying nutrition. So nutrition is very important to get it right for health and for body composition goals, and it can easily be overcomplicated because of the messages that we get, because of vegan, organic, many things, yeah? But in reality, nutrition is very simple, and if you want to take this as a lifestyle, it's very important that we include all the food groups into what we eat, yeah? So food groups being carbohydrates, protein, and fats. Now, the percentage at which you should include these food groups, I will, if needed, specify to you, but everyone pretty much seems or fall into the same place, which is, especially females, we tend to have a lot higher consumption of carbohydrates and lower consumption of protein, simply because we are driven to eat more carbs by nature, and also because simply most of the sweet stuff or the stuff that our body is more appealed to is made of carbs, whether that is fruits, whether that is bread, whether that is pasta, whether that is sugar, etc. Yeah, and protein is something that we only get because it's in the foods every now and then, but it's not something that we will crave, not normally. So every now and then it's okay if you crave a steak or something like that, and if you do, eat it, because it is your body literally telling you something, yeah? But what I wanted to go here, just very, very easy way to approach nutrition on how to start understanding how to find the right balance between carbohydrates, protein, and fats, and obviously greens and fruits. So the way that I like looking at this is by following this amazing infographic, which I will attach to this, is from Precision Nutrition, which is one of the best academies to study nutrition from, and I refer a lot to them because they're very good on these infographics. And so the principles of this infographic is dividing all the food that you can find into green lights, yeah? So green, amber, and red. So green being good, they're healthy, they have lots of nutrients, it's good. Amber being is not good, it's not bad, it's just need to watch on them. I mean, kind of like have a, yeah, not too much, not too little, yeah? And then the red ones, which are gonna be obviously refined sugars, unsaturated fats, trans fats, and protein, but in a really poor source of protein. I'm not demonizing food. Everything on the right place, as I'm saying, is a poor source because it's mainly fat, and it's not precisely the best fat. So it doesn't mean that we have to exclude it completely, but we will just keep it on a small amount as possible. Yeah. So it divides all the groups. Yeah, and so you have the protein sources, the carbohydrate sources, and the fat sources. So all of them. So you actually start, if you look into this infographic, it's very insightful for you to start actually understanding what are carbohydrates, what are protein, what are fats. Keeping always in mind that most of the fruits are compounds, so they can be proteins and carbohydrates, but we will get into that later, yeah? And then, as I explained, if it's in amber, it's not precisely that it's bad, but it can be that as a protein, for example, it might not have as much as a good of a amino acid breakdown of the proteins in red. But if it's the proteins in green. But if it's in red, then it's definitely that the fat content on it is not a good fat source. So this is kind of what we need to start understanding, yeah? And so it explains you what are the good fats, and so it shows all type of nuts, avocado, butter, eggs, low calorie dressing. And then in here it's telling you what not the good fats are, which is margarine, butter, coconut oil. It's very, very insightful. I'm going to send it to you all, yeah? And then in here we have eat the rainbow, which means you should have as many greens as possible in your diet and from all the different colors, because every color provides a different nutrient, okay? And obviously fruits include, fruits I will have two, maximum three portions a day. Yeah? And so in here it tells you how you want to build your plate. And my recommendation for you all is to always build your meals this way. Yeah? So we have a good portion of, and here we have good foods, either this way or this way. So we have foods from the green, we have fruits from the amber, and then we have foods from the red. The red being, I don't know, you can have a pasta with a prosciutto and then have some bacon on top. I'm just making it up, yeah? So it has a little bit of everything. It's very important to have an inclusive diet rather than a restrictive diet, because restriction just leads to obsession. And this is how you can actually build your plates. So you look into this and you say, okay, I like lean beef, I like chicken, I like eggs. So you have four protein sources, you write it in there, yeah? Next, what I want to show next is actually a list, a shopping list that I made. So if all of you eat three main meals a day and one snack a day, yeah, that gives us four different food intake options. And then let's say that you snack on something there and then, fruit or whatever, that will be the extra carbs. That is okay. But four, so which means that we need to be aiming for 20 to 25 grams of protein. Protein as the protein content, not the weight of the protein itself, per meal. So I have created this shopping list in which it explains the meal, the protein, the fats and the carbs. But what I was telling you, especially if you want to start increasing the protein, which is what I would like all of you to focus, those of you who haven't got used to including protein in all of your meals, you will be referring to this table here. So make sure that in every meal you have one of these components. Start by this one, 20 grams, because let's say you have four intakes of 20 grams of protein a day, and the extra proteins that you get from vegetables and the pasta and the legumes, all of them, they have a little bit of extra protein. Let's say you get 100, 110. That is optimal. We don't need more than that. But less than that is not going to be good for your longevity. Remember, we want to build muscle, because muscle is going to keep us younger for longer. It's not just pretty. It's going to keep us younger for longer. And after the menopause, you will be thanking me because I forced you to have more protein. Now, if you the reason why I don't like giving a meal plan is because I don't like restricting your options. You need to have enough information to know, okay, this is the size of the protein and these are the options I have. What do I feel like eating? And then go by three choices and rotate with them, yeah? Very important, the protein, you weigh, so the weight, this is the grams of the protein content, which is not the same of the weight of the chicken itself or the weight of the meat itself. So 90 grams of uncooked chicken, leave the instructions, is 20 grams of protein. 130 grams of uncooked chicken is 30 grams of protein, okay? And you have the same for carbs and fats. But for that, we don't need to stress so much. And we don't need to stress so much as well on the weight being exact. None of you, I mean, very few of you need to or would like to stress about it, but just practice it a few times so you get familiar with it, and every now and then just check that the portion is right. If you are buying something that is already cooked, normally that has this behind the box, it says how much it will be. But this is a very simple option, and I believe all of you with a little bit of effort, with a little bit of time, will create good meal choices, because even I have a skyr in there, which is a Greek yogurt, so you can always add cinnamon and some fruits and honey, and that is an amazing dessert, high in protein. So there is endlessly things you can do there. I will be working on this project, little project that I have, but I'm not sure if it's worth the investment from my side. That's what I need to work out. So far, I want you all to spend some time on this. You will thank me later when you are in your menopause or after your menopause. You will be telling me, or I will be telling you, because I'm older than you, I told you so. Okay, have a good day. Bye-bye. Protein.